लेट स्टार्ट आवर सेशन। वी आर डिले बीन डिलेड बाय 5 मिनट। लेट स्टार्ट द सेशन, लेट अदर जॉइन इन बिटवीन। वॉल्यूम हेलो। Okay, today we will learn regarding design of disc type flywheel, simple disc type flywheel. You can take, say, you want to use a small disc or a disc as a flywheel. So what should be the size, what should be the thickness, what should be the radius of that particular selected material. You can select the material as a cast iron, or you can select the material as a steel. So what should be the size for particular application? So with a small application, we are going to design. So before going for design, let's understand what are the stresses induced in the this type of material. So let's go to the stresses. So we are learning now solid disc flywheel. So we are considering, we have a radius, maximum radius of this flywheel, say capital R. And we are considering element at a radius small r. Thickness of this flywheel, let's consider, say it is T. So this flywheel, say, rotating at mean speed omega. So there will be speed variation. So the maximum speed will be omega max, and minimum speed will be omega minimum. And omega here is the mean speed omega here. So for analysis process, we are taking a small elemental object here at a radius r having thickness say dr. So on this element, different types of stresses will act. So to evaluate these stresses, there are the formulas. So before going for the stresses, let's go for the size requirement, how the size is calculated. The size required for your flywheel, this type flywheel, will depend upon the how much mass moment of inertia is required. So the simplest type of flywheel is solid disc, and the mass moment of inertia of this flywheel can be given by this formula: I is equal to m into r square by 2. That is means I is equal to mk square. So you can say k is equal to here r by 2, r by root 2. So if you take, say, simple disc having radius r, capital R, and thickness t, then your mass moment of inertia is equal to m into r square by 2. Where m is the mass of that disc, okay? Where I is the mass moment of inertia, m is the mass of this disc, r is the outer radius of the disc, that is the maximum radius of the disc here, and this part m is very important. How much mass we are having in that disc? So mass of the disc can be given by this formula. This is very simple formula. It is a cross sectional area into T. You have volume, volume multiplied by the density, we will get the mass. So mass of the disc is equal to pi r square into t into rho. Rho is the density of that material. This disc may be made up of steel material, made up of, say, cast iron material, or any other material. So based on that, you have to take the density of that material. So if you know what is mass moment of inertia is required for that application, that is maximum radius cannot be greater than, then you have to increase the mass. So to get that same mass moment of inertia, you have to increase that mass. So increase of the mass can be done by two ways. So for same radius, you can increase the mass by increasing thickness by keeping the same material, or instead of, say, having, say, a lower density material, you can go for high density material, and you can make your flywheel as compact as possible. So sometimes they will put the limit on R. So if the limit on R is put, then you can increase the mass by varying the thickness. And if there is no limit on the R, you can keep T and R in a proportion, and you can determine the mass required. And that same mass required can be used to get the required value of I. which can be used in the design parameter. So this is the initial basic for mass moment of inertia and mass of the flywheel and the interrelation between mass moment of inertia, the radius and the thickness as well as density of the material. Okay, so let's go for the stresses. Stresses induced in the flywheel. So there are two types of two principal stresses will be used. So one is tangential stress and another is a radial stress. Okay, so tangential stress is like your shear stress, and radial stress will be like your centrifugal stress. So this will be of also this will create a direct effect as a shear, but in a radial direction. This will create a shear in a tangential direction. So there are two principal stresses in the rotating disc here: the tangential stress and radial stress. Tangential stress can be given by this formula: rho v square by 10^6 mu plus 3/8 into 1 minus 3 mu plus 1 upon mu plus 3 into r by r square. So at any radius, you can evaluate the value of tangential stress. So you can vary r from 0 to capital R. Maximum value is equal to r here. So for that, you can check out the what are the values of tangential stresses as well as radial stresses. Radial stresses, again, similar formula. The first two components are same. That is rho v square by 10^6 into mu plus 3/8. Into the bracket, this bracket is changing here. Actually, there is one component here. It is squared to 2.25. So that is missing here. That I'll show in the next slide. It is there. So I'll show it is. This is the exponent is missing here. The exponent here to this bracket exponent is 2.25. For this bracket there is no exponent. So it is 1 minus r by r the bracket here. This much. So this is the radial stress and this is tangential stress. So these values are in Newton per millimeter square. So if you put these values here, v in meter per second, mu ratio. R by R is the ratio. So whether you take in millimeter or meter, it doesn't make any sense here. Rho you have to take in kg per meter cube. So if you take this value and this 10^6 is adjusted so that you get sigma t and sigma r in terms of Newton per millimeter square. And v is your peripheral velocity, that is r into omega. This value you have to take in meter per second in this calculation. Now if you look at this formulas, so the values of sigma t and sigma r vary with respect to r, small r. So when this value will be maximum? So if you look at this diagram, so this is 1 minus something. So if r is greater than 0, this will be 1 minus something. So it would be a fraction. So this fraction will be less than 1. So it seems that sigma r is maximum is this part. So for that, this term r, this term has to be 0. So this term will be 0 when r is at the center, that is r is equal to 0. So when r is equal to 0, sigma ri is equal to maximum. Similarly, in this relation, if you see this relation, this r by r is multiplied to this coefficient here. So this coefficient for the same material is constant. So as you change r, this product will going to change. So this product is 1 minus this, so this fraction is going to change. So again, this is a fraction which will be less than 1 or equal to 1. So this will be equal to 1 only when this part is equal to 0. So this product will be 0 when r is equal to 0. So sigma t is also happens to be maximum when r is equal to 0. So the maximum tangential and radial stresses are equal. You can see if you put r is equal to 0 and r equal to 0, so you get sigma t and sigma r equal to, they are equal. And this occurs at r is equal to 0. So this is the maximum value and the maximum values of sigma t and sigma r, they are equal and it happens at r equal to 0. So therefore, sigma t max or sigma r max is equal to rho v square upon 10^6 into mu plus 3/8. So this is the maximum stress induced in your flywheel material and which happens to be at r is equal to 0. Why we have to calculate this? This is equal to 0 is nothing but your shaft material. So if your shaft is not capable of taking these stresses, then flywheel may remain safe, but your shaft may fail. So it is necessary to evaluate the maximum tangential and radial stress at r is equal to 0. So let's go for a simple problem here. So I am taking very small problem here. Okay, so this is the problem statement. Design a cast iron flywheel. So here the material is also specified for four stroke IC engine. The input device is IC engine here, developing 50 HP at 300 RPM. So normal power supply here is 300 50 HP at 300 RPM. So 300 RPM is your mean speed here. So this is your mean speed. The total fluctuation of the speed is limited to 3% of mean speed. So total fluctuation in the speed, that is W max minus W minimum upon W, is permitted in the range of 3%. So if you write in terms of that total fluctuation in terms of percentage, it is 3% of mean speed. Then the work done during power stroke. So normally it is four stroke cycle. So when power stroke happens, work done supplied by the engine is greater than the normal work requirement. So the work done during power stroke is 30% more than the average work done during the full cycle. Okay. So the work done or power supplied in power stroke is 30% more than the average power required. Okay. Means average work requirement there. Find the diameter of the supporting the flywheel. So we are going to design here CI5 flywheel, as well as you have to determine the diameter of the shaft to support the flywheel. Okay, so let's write down the given data here. So in this we have given data, that is power is equal to 50 HP. Okay, so you have to convert in kilowatt here. So this 50 HP can be converted by multiplying by 745 watt, because 1 HP is around 745 watt. So exactly it is 745.7 watt. So I am converting in kilowatt. So this is equal to 0.7457 into 50 HP here. So this will be converted into now kilowatt. So the kilowatt power is 37.285 kilowatt. So your engine is developing 37.285 kilowatt power. The mean speed of the engine here is 300 RPM. So mean speed of the engine is 300 RPM. So based on the 300 RPM, let's evaluate the mean angular speed omega. So mean angular speed omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60. So n is here 300. So 2 pi into 300 by 60. So you will have your angular speed as 31.4 radian per second. Okay. So this is your angular speed. We have given in the problem the variation of the speed, which is in the control limit of 3% mean speed. So we have been given here coefficient of fluctuation of speed. So coefficient of fluctuation of speed by formula, we have CS is equal to W max minus W minimum upon W. And in this problem, it is given that fluctuation of speed is permitted of 3%, means your coefficient of fluctuation of speed is around 0.03. So CS here is 0.03. So you can get the maximum fluctuation of speed W max minus W minimum is equal to 0.03 into omega. So omega we have evaluated, that is 31.4. So maximum fluctuation of speed can be of the order of 0.942 radian per second. So this much of variation in the speed will be permitted from minimum to maximum, so that the average speed of 31.4 radian per second is maintained. Then also given the power supplied or stored in the flywheel. So when we create excess energy, so that excess energy is normally stored in the flywheel. And whenever that energy is required, when we don't have much energy supplied by the engine, so that time excess energy will be supplied by the flywheel to maintain the speed of the engine. So for that, let's go to the diagram of previously we have learned in the previous chapter. This diagram we have learned here. So what we required is the mean torque. So mean torque we have a will be calculating here. So what we been given here, it is a four stroke engine, and in the power stroke, this is your power stroke, that is from 2 pi to 3 pi here. So in the power stroke, the extra energy developed by the engine, this is the extra energy developed by the engine. So above this mean torque line, the extra energy developed, and that is given in the problem, that this extra energy developed, this part developed, is equal to 30%, that is 30% of work done in one cycle. So work done, the one complete cycle here is for 2 pi. So this is one complete cycle. another cycle is here. So this is another cycle, because it, since it is four stroke engine, so there will be to complete four stroke cycle you require two RPMs here. So but actually one cycle is one revolution, one cycle is one revolution. So you can consider either this part, or you can consider only this part, and you can consider this percentage is 30% of this part or this part requirement here. Okay, so if you go to the diagram here, maybe I make some mistake in the calculation or assumption, so you can correct as and when required here. So we are coming back to the calculation now. The energy supplied or stored in flywheel, which is given in the problem as 30% of more than average work done, so 30% of average work done in the cycle. So 30% means 30 by 100, and work done in a cycle, you know, work done in a cycle for one complete revolution, we required 2 phi angle is there, and average torque requirement is Tm. So average torque is required is Tm. So you can calculate Tm here. So Tm can be calculated based on the power supplied here. Power supplied is 37.285. So power is equal to 2 pi n Tm upon 60,000. So from this we can determine the mean torque level Tm. So mean torque level required here, power is 37.285 kilowatt, 2 pi, RPM here is 300, average RPM, into mean torque. Mean torque is unknown, so we are going to evaluate that. So since we are taking power in kilowatt, so it is divided by 60,000, n is taken in RPM, so divided by 60. So this we get mean torque in terms of Newton meter here, that is 1186.81 Newton meter. Okay, so this is the mean torque requirement for the your engine here. And now out of this mean torque requirement, power stroke will develop large torque, and remaining places the torque requirement may be less, but that excess torque will provide excess energy, and that excess energy will be stored in the flywheel. So therefore the energy supplied or stored by the flywheel will be equal to, that is excess energy, that is U naught is equal to now 30% of 2 pi Tm. So 2 pi Tm is the value of work done in one cycle. It is the value of work done in one cycle. One cycle means it is not the working cycle, it is the one revolution. So you have to write here for one revolution what is the work done here. So that is equal to 30 here. So 30% of this work done requirement for one revolution. So that is equal to 30% means 0.3 into 2 pi into Tm. Tm is evaluated here, 1186.81. So the excess energy which will be stored in the flywheel or supplied by the flywheel as and when required is equal to 2237.1 joule. So this much energy will be supplied here. Now the relation between energy supplied and coefficient of fluctuation of speed. This formula we have learned in the last lecture. I am having that formula. I will show this how this formula is come here. Here this formula. Based on our fluctuation of speed analysis, this formula has come. So the excess energy requirement is equal to 1 by 2 I omega square into Cs. So based on the Cs value and the energy requirement and the average speed maintenance point of view, what should be the value of I? So this value can be calculated in the problem. Okay, so let's go to the problem again. So in the problem statement, we have used this value. Here you can see U naught is equal to 1 by 2 I omega square into Cs. Now in this, we have put this calculated value of energy requirement, that is the 2237.1, 1 by 2 into I. I is unknown here, because since you are designing this flywheel, so I value will be geometry factor, so it will be unknown, geometry and mass factor here, so it will be unknown here. Omega is calculated, so that is 31.4 radian per second. So that value will be put here, omega square into Cs, which is given in the problem, that is Cs, coefficient of speed of fluctuation here, that is 0.03. And from this, we come to know, we required a mass moment of inertia of the flywheel to, equal to 151.26 kg per meter square. Okay, kg meter square. So this value of mass moment of inertia is required. So if you supply a flywheel of this mass moment of inertia, then it will meet the requirement of energy, that that is this energy, as well as it will maintain the fluctuation of the speed within the limit of 3%. Okay, otherwise if you supply say flywheel or provide a flywheel having I less than this, so what will be happening? So there will be a change in the fluctuation of the speed will be greater than 3%. Or if you supply a flywheel greater than this value, say I greater than this value, then what will be happening? Then the fluctuation of the speed will be less than 3%. So it is better. So when the minimum value of I we should have in our flywheel should be equal to 151.26 or greater than this. So let's go and determine the geometry of flywheel here in the next slide. So in the next slide, you can see here, we have the formula for mass of the flywheel. Okay, so based on the mass moment of inertia of the flywheel, I is equal to mr square by 2. Okay, so we know, right now we know the value of I, so let's evaluate the value of m, mass of the flywheel required here. So we can put the value of I here, that is equal to 151.26. M is unknown, R is also unknown because we are not designed, so R is also unknown. So we get this M into R square by 2. So let's evaluate M here. So R will come on this side. So 2 will go here up. So mass of flywheel in terms of R will be M is equal to 302.52 upon R square, where R is in meter here. This is the mass we are getting from mass moment of inertia requirement. But by geometry and the density of the material, the mass of the disk can be given by m is equal to pi r square t into rho. So this is the formula we have seen in the second slide. So this is the mass of the disk, simple formula. Now in this, r is unknown, t is unknown, rho is, since we know the material, material is what? The cast iron material. So for cast iron material, the density of the material is 7300. kg per meter cube. It is per meter cube. So the density of the material is 7300 kg per meter cube. Now you have to solve this problem. So you have to make certain assumption. So we are making that assumption as thickness of the flywheel, that is this t value, we are taking in proportion of radius. So let's take say 50% of radius. So 0.15 r. So this is the assumption we have made. So by putting this value of assumption value of t here and rho here, we get the mass of the flywheel. So we are getting here mass of the flywheel is equal to pi r square into t into rho. So r is unknown, t is known now in terms of r, that is 0.15 r into 7300. So this value, this product we get as coefficient as 3440 point something, but we can ignore that point because this value is bigger. So 3.440 into r cube, so r square into r will become r cube. So this is the mass of the flywheel by geometry. This is the mass of the flywheel required from the mass moment of inertia. And we can say this and this are equal. So we are equating this mass and this mass here, flywheel. So from that we can determine the radius. So this value is mass is equal to 3440 r cube and this value is 302.52 upon r square. So by equating these two masses, radius of the flywheel, we come to, if we evaluate this value, r in terms of meter, we get it is 0.6149 meter. So in terms of millimeter, it is 614.9 millimeter. So approximated value is 15 millimeter. But once you cross 500 mm, the sizes available are not in multiple of 5. Even though I have written 5 mm here, but they are not available in multiple of 5. They will be available in multiple of 25 or 50 there. So actually we have to select 625, but that will become a very big size. So that's why I've selected 615. You can turn out the material and you can use this 615 millimeter radius of the flywheel. Thickness of the flywheel we have assumed as 0.15 r. So based on the thickness of the flywheel, so thickness of the flywheel is equal to 92.25 mm. 90 or 100 mm thickness will be sufficient here to select for the flywheel. So this is the geometry calculation we have done for the disk type flywheel. Now when you get these values, then there will be stresses induced in this flywheel. So the stress calculation is also important here. So when you calculate the stresses, so So we have to use formulas. These are the formulas available in the data book. In the data book, the design for dish type flywheel is not available. Please, in the data book, the design is available for arm type flywheel. And there also the formulas are given are very limited. Data given in the data book is also limited. So certain data, especially the density of the material, you have to remember, or you have to identify from proper location from the data book, and you have to get the density of that material, either cast iron or steel are normally used. Mostly cast iron is used because the size of the flywheels are very big, especially if you are using, say, Fortuk cycle engine or a diesel engine. Then the size of the flywheel is very big compared to the petrol engine or say two-stroke cycle. So for four-stroke cycle, we require a bigger flywheel. So normally we go for cast iron material. Okay. So considering this cast iron material, we have to check the induced stresses, and the induced stresses value should be lesser than certain values or permissible values. So permissible values may be available in the data book based on the material property. So let's go for the stresses in the flywheel. To evaluate stresses in the flywheel, you need a very peripheral speed in terms of meter per second. So peripheral speed is equal to R omega. So R in terms of meter, that is, we have taken as 615 millimeter, that is 0.615 meter into omega. Omega here is 31.4. So this comes out to be 19.31 meter per second. Now stresses at various location based on the radius. So let's calculate stresses at outer surface, means your R is equal to capital R. So sigma t is equal to here. Just 1 minute, there is a problem with the sharing. Wait for, I have lost the connection. So once I regain the connection of the laptop, I will continue the remaining part. So wait for a few minutes. Okay, now it's visible again. So we have come to the calculation of stresses in the flywheel. So I'm magnifying it. So tangential stress and radial stress. So these are the formulas. I told that there is a exponent coefficient of 2.25. In earlier slide, it was not properly visible. So this for sigma t, there is an exponent here of 2.25. For sigma r, there is no exponent. Okay, so this is the tangential stress, and this is the radial stress. So radial stress is normally called as centripetal stress, and tangential stress will be called as if you take a ream type material, the tangential stress is of the order it is like a tensile stress. So that's why it is t for tangential as well as t for tensile. Okay, so in this rho v square, v to be taken in meter per second, mu could be Poisson ratio here for the material. Now this Poisson ratio has to be taken for cast and material. R here, where you are evaluating this stress. So let's evaluate at the outer surface, means R is equal to capital R here. So for R is equal to capital R, we are going to evaluate these values here. So if you put these values of R is equal to capital R, so R by R will become 1. So this fraction will become 1. So remaining, if you find out the, now Poisson ratio for cast and material, again, Poisson ratio for cast and material, there is a variation from 0.2 to 0.31. Average value of cast iron, say gray cast iron material is around 0.22 or 0.23, and general cast iron material is around 0.27. So you can take mu as 0.22 or 0.25 or 0.27 depending upon the grade of the cast iron. So I'm taking the lower value here, say gray cast iron, considering gray cast iron, let's take a Poisson ratio of 0.22 here. So putting these values here, we have rho density of the cast iron 7300, velocity, your peripheral velocity is 19.31 meter per second. So 19.31 meter per second here. Then your Poisson ratio 0.22, then plus 3 divided by 8, 10 is to 6. This 10 is to 6 is adjusted such that you have, you will get this sigma t value or sigma r value in terms of Newton per millimeter square. Okay, then this part is 3 mu plus 1, so 3 into 0.22 plus 1 upon mu plus 3, 0.22 plus 3. Since we are taking outer surface radius is equal to capital R, so R by R will become 1 here. So this 1 square will become 1. So if you do this calculation, sigma t we get as 0.214 Newton per millimeter square. So we get tensile stress here as 0.214, tangential stress as 0.214 Newton per millimeter square. Sigma r here, when you put capital R is equal to small r is equal to capital R, so 1 minus 1 will become 0 here. So sigma r at outer radius will be equal to 0. So the radial stress is 0 at the surface and it will go on increasing as the radius decreases. Okay, so let's go for the maximum stress in the flywheel is happening at the center is equal to 0. Sigma t max upon sigma is equal to sigma r max, that is equal to rho v square upon 10 raised to 6 mu plus 3 upon 8. So 7800 into 19.31 square upon 10 raised to 6 into 0.22 plus 3, 0.22 is my Poisson ratio here, upon 8 is equal to 1.17 Newton per meter square. Now whether these induced stresses are below the limit or not, I have just calculated. But they are below the limit because the permissible values of your tensile stresses in the cast iron material are of the order of 65 kgf per centimeter square. So 65 kgf per centimeter square means it is 6.5 Newton per millimeter square. So 65 divided by 10, you will get Newton per millimeter square. So it is of the order of permissible value is of the order of 6.5 Newton per millimeter square for cast iron material. So this value is given in the PAG data book 7.120. So you can refer 7.120 and 121 page, 7.121 page for PAG for data. But there the design process is available for arm type flywheel. It is not for a disc type flywheel. It is arm type flywheel. We are going to, in the next class, we are going to learn arm type flywheel. So from that we can conclude here, the induced stresses are less than the, I have not written that statement, you can write that statement. Induced stresses are less than the permissible stresses. Permissible stresses is of the order of 6.5 Newton per millimeter square for flywheel here. So we get the given geometry, that is a radius of 615 millimeter and a thickness of 92.25 millimeter. So flywheel will be safe under working stresses here. Okay, now you need to mount this flywheel on a shaft. So you need to have diameter of the shaft. So diameter of the shaft, shaft will not be a say cast iron material. Shaft will be your steel material. So we need to know what is the torque transmitted here. So this is the mean torque. So I have just calculated mean cost. This is not the my final calculation. Whether my this calculation is correct or wrong, whether my this calculation for diameter calculation is correct or wrong, I have not completed my problem. I have done to this extent and then I started my lecture. So a small one step calculation, further calculation is needed. Whether my this this calculation is correct or wrong, so somebody can unmute and comment. People can unmute and comment whether this calculation is correct or any changes need to be done here. Whether we can use TM here or TMX here. Yes, anybody? Because design of shaft you all learn many times. You can put into the chat box whether it is correct or wrong, whether you have to use TM or TMAX there. Now, if I see in my presentation, I have not erased the previous lecture slide data. The reason is for that only. If you see this diagram here, okay, I have kept this diagram to be that point exactly where we do wrong calculation, where we go wrong. Say this is the torque supplied by the engine, okay, so which is connected to your shaft. The engine is connected to your shaft. So shaft has to transmit that torque. So when engine is supplying this torque, TM, then the design calculation is very simple. But engine is not supplying the TM same time. Engine is supplying less value, engine is supplying more value, and engine is supplying very, very large value. So what is supplying? It is supplying TM. So when we are doing this calculation here, you should take this instead of TM, you have to take this as a TMAX. Now, how will you evaluate TMAX here? Okay, so this is the minimum. Say, if I assume there is an average torque acting on that shaft, so average for that average torque and for steel material with a keyway, permissible value of tau is 45 Newton per millimeter square. Without keyway, it is 55 Newton per millimeter square. So, considering keyway, because you have to mount this flywheel on that shaft, so we could have keyway, so our bolting mechanism. So considering keyway, we are taking 45. But this is the mean value. But actual torque acting on the shaft may be greater than mean value of the order of Tmax. So in the design, you have to use Tmax value there. So how will you use this Tmax value? For that, how much energy we are extra energy we are supplying, that we should know. How much extra energy we are supplying here? We are supplying, say, in this problem, how much extra energy supplied? 30% more than the average work done. So average work done is related to the power. So power is related to mean torque, 2 pi n Tm by 60,000. Suppose if I supply Tmax, then my power will be almost 1.3 times because it is 30% more. So it is more than 30% times. So similarly, when I am taking this value here, Tm, so it should, instead of Tm, I should use here Tmax, and that Tmax value will be greater than T minimum, T min value by 30% more as per the problem statement here. Because it is showed that the work done during power stroke is 30% more than the average work done during the whole cycle. So 30% more means 1.3 times more, the mean torque value. So maximum torque will be 1.3 times torque value. So in this design calculation, if I do this now calculation here, let's do this calculation. So I'm removing this presentation and let's do this calculation here. So this value will be equal to here. This value will be not Tm. So this will be Tmax. And that will be now here 1.3 into your average mean value, which is in, this is in Newton meter, so you have to play, since you are evaluating D in millimeter here, so multiply by 1000, so it gets converted into Newton millimeter, pi by 16, 45 into D cube. Now the D will change, so if you calculate this revised value of D here, So let's say we are calculating this revised value of B here. If you cannot see, so I'm just magnifying it so you can see the calculation here. So we are calculating here, say by calculating. Okay, so let's do this calculation here. 1.3 into 1186.81 into 1000 into 16 divided by 3.14, that is 5, divided by again 45. So this value is your cube. 174703, ये अपना डी क्यूब आ रहा है. सो वी वी वॉन्ट टू नो द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस इन डी वैल्यू. सो 1/3 ये लेना है. ओके, सो दिस इज अवर आंसर. सो लेट्स गो फॉर एक्स बाय वाई. सो वी आर टेकिंग इट टू द लेवल ऑफ से 1/3. सो लेट्स पुट द ब्रैकेट हियर बिकॉज 1/3 आप लेना है. तो डिवाइड बाय 3 क्यूब रूट लेना है. तो क्यूब रूट लेने के बाद यू गेट दिस वैल्यू. डायमीटर है 55.90. सो अर्लियर इट वाज 51 पॉइंट समथिंग. सो नाउ हियर इट इज 55.90. सो 55.90, सो दैट इज मींस यू रिक्वायर अप्रोक्सीमेटली इक्वल टू 56 mm. You require the diameter here approximately equal to 56 mm. So then your design calculation is correct. Have you understood this? That fluctuation of energy, the coefficient of fluctuation of energy is important, and your maximum torque is related to the maximum energy supplied over and above the mean torque value. So based on that, you require the diameter of the shaft here of the order of having steel material, having say commercial shafting, having permissible shear stress value of 45 newton per millimeter square. So that value is equal to 56. Again, see, as per our design calculation, the maximum stress in the flywheel happens at the center. Now, if you are using shaft, the center will be the shaft center. So whatever the permissible value we are using here, this value is 45 newton per millimeter square, induced value here is 1.11. Suppose induced value is very, very large, say if it is coming say 60 newton per millimeter square, then if you are designing for 45, then there is a chance your shaft itself will fail under the action of flywheel moment. Flywheel stresses will create the stresses in the shaft, and it may fail your shaft also. Okay, so this is regarding the design of this type flywheel, simple this type flywheel. So this is a problem I have taken from the university examination, asked for 10 to 12 marks. So similar problems will be asked. Even they can ask the problem on your arm type flywheel. But if it is specified, then only you have to go for arm type flywheel. Otherwise, you can design your simple disc type flywheel. So this is regarding the topic on design of flywheel, disc type flywheel. So next lecture we will take problem on design of flywheel for arm type flywheel. So there we will be using more of PSG formulae. But if you have been asked to design a disc type flywheel, please remember this formula. These formulas are not available in PSG data. Whatever formula I have given here, these are the textbook formulas. They are available in PSG data Bhandari book. But they are not available in your this formula here. That this is raised to 2.25. Here, this formula. These two formulas, please remember, these formulas are not available in PSG data book. If this type flywheel is used, then you have to use this formula. And this formula is given in Bhandari book, so you can refer Bhandari book to understand the design of this type flywheel. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can ask the doubt by unmuting and by putting your putting the chat message. If you have a doubt, you can ask. Have you understood the design of flywheel? The design of flywheel will be the based on the mass moment of inertia. The geometry calculation is based on the mass moment of inertia. For that mass moment of inertia, you should know fluctuation of speed, you should know fluctuation of energy. And from the fluctuation of speed and fluctuation of energy, you can determine the required value of mass moment of inertia. And then you can determine the geometry. And once you determine the geometry, you can take the induced stresses. And induced stresses has to be less than the permissible stresses for that material. Then your design is complete. Otherwise, your design may be incomplete. Since the shaft material is sometimes other than the flywheel material, so sometimes you need to design the shaft also with appropriate material. But it is not always asked to design the shaft. It is basically because it is not a part of your syllabus. But sometimes it is asked, you can write down that shaft design based on the maximum torque requirement and also check for the stresses at the center. Okay, so if you don't have any doubt, so I will declare the session is over. So you can leave the meeting.